start to deal with a patient with diabetes, firstly, we start to deal with the symptoms and signs, and then after that, we ask ourselves a very important question. And this question is very strongly to be answered before we start the treatment. What is the type of diabetes in our patient we start to treat? The type of diabetes to differentiate very, very important. Classically, you have a type 1, and classically, you have a type 2 diabetes. After that, you have a usual and unusual form of diabetes. All of us, I think, know that the type 1 diabetes, classically young patient, coming with the aggressive weight loss, polysymptom, polyuria, polydipsia, and so on. And this patient sometimes coming with an emergency, like diabetic ketoacidosis, and the hyper one would be important. Hyperglycemic emergency with the severe weight loss, aggressive dehydration, with the ketonemia in the blood and the ketonuria in the blood, and with the impairment of the electrolytes, likely potassium and sodium and so on. And this type of patient, as you know, must be treated by insulin therapy, and the best regimen is the basal bolus insulin with a short-acting insulin at mean, and basal insulin at bedtime. After that, we have another type 2 diabetes. Classically, all of you know what about type 2? It's an obese one. Coming with risk of obesity, sedentary life, history of gestational diabetes, patient have a dyslipidemia, both of family history of diabetes, of a previous pregnancy having a large-sized baby, and so on. And this type treated firstly by diet, lifestyle intervention. After that, patient treated by oral anti-diabetic drug. For some time after that, shifted to insulin therapy. What about other types? We have a gestational diabetes that likely under another type of diabetes pregnancy. Not all diabetes pregnancy is gestational, because diabetes pregnancy contains all types of diabetes that can create the late pregnancy in the childbearing baby. So type 1 get pregnant, type 2 get pregnant, 3 diabetic 1 get pregnant, and all these are diabetes pregnancy. But what about gestational diabetes? This should be that in non-diabetic women, that this type of diabetes discovered at week 18 up to 25 and more. And so this type of diabetes is gestational diabetes in non-diabetic women and must be screened for any obese in females with a history of family history of diabetes. You must screen for this type of diabetes, likely to diagnose by 75 oral glucose trans test or 100 oral glucose trans test to diagnose. What about treatment? The majority of women in this type of gestational diabetes treated by lifestyle intervention and so on, by diet and so on. And another group who not controlled by diet and so on must be treated by insulin only. And today we have some data regarding metformin and the glipizide, but still waiting for FDA approval. So insulin is mandatory, especially short-acting insulin with some new analog that treat this type. What about other types? We have another unusual types of diabetes regarding what about drugs that induce diabetes. I think we have a many drugs that work well with patient with the many indication, like some hormones like estrogen, progesterone, some thyroxine, some corticosteroid treatment, and so on. These drugs can induce diabetes well, some diuretic, and so on. So be cautious that when using this diabetes, added to this some antipsychotic drug. So if you use this drug well and your patient have hyperglycemia, that's called drug-induced diabetes. What about one of the other usual types of diabetes, the secondary diabetes? And this secondary diabetes, and this type induced by another disease, endogenously affect one of the endocrine gland, likely thyrotoxicosis, and in a patient start to have a thyrotoxic symptom with a hypercatabolic state, likely maybe Graves' disease and more. And this type can get the patient a chance to have a hyperglycemia, and the hyperglycemia after thyrotoxic states this cold and the secondary diabetes due to thyroid problem. What about Cushing syndrome due to hypercortisolemia, either the problem from suprarenal gland or pituitary, and added to this also acromegaly due to hypersecretion of growth hormone and more. We have a many disease can induce diabetes. So if you examine your patient well and study your patient by examination well, and that's important to deal with this type according to others. We have a many neurological syndromes and so on. So by knowing the type of diabetes, you can deal with your patient well. How? So you can control glycemic state well, but you can control the inducing the disease well, either complete treatment or controlling this disease, and then this can reflect well to the glycemic state, either controlled or maybe completely treated. And so knowing this type will always help you to predict the prognosis well. How can you predict the prognosis? From the types. If you have a patient likely have gestational diabetes and treat your patient well, after labor, all diabetic state return back to normal and the patient become return back to glycemic state. But you should her to educate your patient well about how can she deal with diet, weight, lifestyle, and so on to prevent incoming type 2 diabetes. And the gestational diabetes, this one type that can give the female a chance to transform from one type to the other. How? She started gestational and end type 2 diabetes after that and treat. And you can prevent? Yes, you can prevent this type. And by knowing this different types, you can give your patient a chance to have a good to do well. What about another unusual types? We have the type what's called the monogenic diabetes, either MODY, maturity onset diabetes of young, that become present in the adolescent stage and become very minimally enlarged, just fasting postprandial at the time of presentation of type 1, but not classic type 1. That's called the monogenic diabetes, and we have a many subtypes of monogenic that's called the MODY, M-O-D-Y. What about another unusual type of LADA, late autoimmune diabetes of adults, and that's present in the adult one. And all criteria of type 1 coming in this late type 1, and that's late type 1 is LADA, late autoimmune diabetes of adults. All this type, it's LADA treated by insulin only. And by knowing this type, you can give your patient chance to treat it early and be controlled and to prevent complication likely like type 1 diabetes. And thank you very much.